Good morning, good morning.
Good morning.
And thank you for coming and sharing your day with us at Promised Land Ministries Incorporated here in Peachtree Corner. Mm-hmm. Before we get started with our service today, we just have a few announcements before the man of God come up and give you the food for today. The first thing is we want you to share this ministry, share the word of God. And we want you to subscribe. If you look on your page, please push that push the subscribe button and share with your friends and be one with us. It's one body of Christ.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. And don't forget to give. This is a community resource. Mm-hmm. So we need your help to grow so we can be a help to you as we grow together in one body of Christ. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
What the Bible say? The Bible says it's better to be obedient than to sacrifice.
That's
amen.
That's right. That's right.
Amen. We have great news. We have great news. Mm-hmm. Boaz Institute is coming May 15th.
Woo-hoo!
The meeting for the class will be May 15th, and Pastor Charles Lucas, he will go into details, and I'm telling you guys, come grow, come
yes.
grow, come grow, come grow.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And please volunteer. Mm-hmm. He's going to need help with this ministry. Amen.
Yes, that's
Amen.
Right.
Amen. Come volunteer. Come down when we have service. Mm-hmm. Come down to Bible study.
Yes.
He's going to be on... You do it online, right, Pastor?
Yes, yes, yes.
Tune in online. Amen. Amen. It'll be a chance, especially the babies in Christ, it'll be a chance to ask questions.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
He's hands-on. He's hands-on. Most leaders I know, it's hard to be hands-on.
It is.
He's hands-on. He loves his members. Amen.
That's right.
Amen. Like I said, Wednesday Bible study will be 7 o'clock sharp.
Amen.
7 o'clock sharp. So tune in.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
And I would like to welcome new members.
Amen.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. We love you for giving us the chance to help you grow.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
I thank you for helping me grow. This
Amen.
Is helping me grow. Amen.
Wow.
Thank you for tuning in. Amen. And before I go, it's my personal love,
yes.
thoughts, and care. To all the mothers.
Thank you.
I'm telling you, motherhood is a hard occupation.
Yes, it is.
Amen.
It is. You're
Amen.
Right. That's right.
And I thank you. And personally, I want to give a special Mother's Day love to Mom Green and Mom Johnson. Thank
Amen.
You for so much for being there for me.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
So I thank you and I love you.
Praise God.
Happy Mother's Day, First
Happy
Lady.
Mother's Day. Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen. Well, I'm going to turn this over to Pastor.
Yes.
Pastor, you come.
Okay.
So I'm going to turn the
Thank
service
you.
Over to Pastor at the time.
Thank you. Beautiful. Beautiful job.
Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, thank Excellent. You, Pastor. Love you.
Well, amen. Thank you. We are so proud and we love. I call her Sergeant Dixon. And we're so happy. We're proud of our members.
Yes.
We're proud of Gina and the baby got a car today.
Yeah.
What? Come on. You better give God glory. That's our baby.
Yes.
That's our youngest. And
That's
we call
baby.
Her baby up in here,
yes.
you know. That's our baby. You better come over. Give me a hug, Tay. I'm proud. Look, hey, that's the baby. She got her a car. Amen. So we got to get her a gas card, y'all.
Yeah.
She's free.
Yes, that's right.
And look at and guess what? And thank you for Brother Kevin being here mm-hmm. serving. You know, God blessed him with a new job, and he's doing well, and
yes,
he's always
he
he's brilliant.
Yes,
you
thank
know?
You.
Brilliant. He's going to be teaching me how to play golf. And guess what? Kevin's a very successful man in Atlanta. But guess what? He made his way here. He could be anywhere.
Yeah.
You know, And he's a success story here in Atlanta, but he uses his talent he brought before God. Sergeant could be anywhere. Mm-hmm. Gina and Tay could be anywhere.
That's right.
Could be the elder young could be anywhere.
Yes.
And we thank God that they have chose to give to God. And we know that they have promise. And again, we thank you for Sergeant. We give God, give Sergeant
Amen.
Dixon And we know, we believe that she's called to do great things in the city mm-hmm. of Atlanta and East Point. She's already doing great things in the yeah. city of Atlanta and East Point, mm-hmm. and it's only going to get better. And for her to be here to drive an hour away to
right.
come and
That's right.
give to the kingdom of God,
yeah.
we
yeah.
praise God for that.
Amen.
And we want to say happy Mother's Day to all you mothers.
Yes.
We love you. I love you. First Lady loves you.
That's right.
Mama loves you. Yeah. Amen. So I'm gonna hand out these roses before we get started over here, and I'm just gonna go from First Lady on and thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Mama.
Thank you.
We love you, Sergeant Dixon. Thank
so
you,
pretty.
And I don't
Cold.
Take for granted the sacrifice that y'all have made to be here, and you know I love you. God, come on. Huh? Come on. Huh?
You're so crazy.
Thank you. Thank you, and I appreciate y'all. I value the moms. I value that you guys are the busiest people on the planet and will take time for us. And the Lord has just given me just a heart for you to understand that guess what? You're smiling because this is your season.
Yes.
All of that sowing was not in vain.
That's right.
Don't
That's
let
right.
the devil fool you mothers into believing that the sacrifice that you gave was not worth it.
Mm-hmm.
Look at your children. They not perfect, but because they not in prison because you did something right.
Mm-hmm.
And the devil would like to beat you up about ain't nobody perfect.
Mm-hmm.
Amen? Huh? But you can look and shift your head up and be proud and say, you know what? My children are better because of me.
Yeah.
I want you to just repeat after me. My children,
my children
are better because of me.
Because of me.
And that's the truth,
mm-hmm.
right? That cancels out what the devil says. And guess what? Your children, even if you're looking at your children, love you. No matter what, mothers, if you make mistakes, everybody, the devil wants you to think you're the only mama ever made a mistake. You're the only one ever dropped your child. You're the only one ever yelled at him. Only one ever threw a shoe. Yeah, yeah, huh? All of us want to get Wu-Tang on our children, right? Yeah, right? That's right. We want to get ODB on them, but we can't do that, right? We can't get Brooklyn on them. My wife said, cut it off. So it is my pleasure, you know, to welcome the mother of this house, the first lady, you know, Bonita Lucas, and she is a great mother of three, grandmother of two, and because of her sacrifices, her kids have, just like yours, have grown up, and she's got a story, she's got a testimony, and she's going to minister to us today and feed the sheep today. And let's clap our hand and get
Amen.
Ready for sister for Minister Lucas over here. Amen.
I wasn't trying to be selfish. It's just that my husband is a talker, and he's cutting into my time.
I love you, dear. I wore these white shorts for you. Remember that. All right? Be gentle.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Everybody, praise the Lord. Okay, I had to bring my rose up here because it's just so beautiful. So beautiful, my roses. Okay, so we're going to begin with prayer this morning. So if you'll just bow your head with me. And Lord God, we just thank you for this time. We thank you for this opportunity, God, just to say thank you for allowing us to see another Mother's Day. God, we just thank you for all the mothers that were able to get up this morning. Thank you, God, for the ones whose hearts you are chasing to reach out to mother this morning, even after years, God. And we thank you, Lord. Lord, I ask that I decrease as you increase, as I give your word, Lord. Take over, Holy Spirit. Have your way. Have your way in this temple that belongs to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
So once again, we say what? Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day.
So my first scripture is going to come out of Proverbs 31, 26. And of course it says, Happy Mother's Day. I might go a little bit faster because when I'm nervous, I talk fast. Mm-hmm. So if y'all, if you're not able to get the scripture, just kind of jot it down and get it later. Go back for to it later. The title is Superwoman, The Power of a Praying Mother. Hey. Yeah, we make it look easy, don't we? We make it look easy, but it's hard. Mm. It's hard. And people do consider us superwomen. Why? Because they depend on mom. They depend on mom for all kinds of things. And that's what you're going to learn and see today, why we're known as superwoman. I mean, dad is there. He's going to be there, but he's there for other reasons, like that wallet, you know. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and the teaching of kindness is on her tongue. Once again, that's Proverbs 31, 26. What is a mother? What is a mother? Don't be laughing at my stuff, y'all. This is a real person, y'all. Amen. All right? We need to pray for people like this. Amen. All right? Because sometimes, I will tell y'all one thing. I have been a little of both. I've never been to prison. Amen. But my kids will tell you, Mama crazy. No, I wasn't crazy. I was just not going to let y'all handle me like that. You know? I had to enforce the rules. Because there was a time in my life I became a single parent. Amen. And so I had a daughter and a son, and my boy, if y'all see, he's big. He's like Dondre that comes back here. He's big, and I could just see that one day, this boy is going to be a teenager. He's going to try me. I knew that. I knew that for a fact. So I put the fear in them when they were younger. So sometimes they might have seen me looking like this, all right? And then others have seen me like this. So some might say, yeah, this is a good mother, godly. We seen, it's not, I'm not going to say that and discourage people, but this is like back in the day, mama, you know, you go into the room, you see mama with a Bible open, praying, big mama, grandmama Medea, you know, praying. And then you got the bad mom who's, she did the best she could. Amen. Okay. Her choices may not have always been right, but she did the best she could. She felt it maybe have fall into bad relationships. We don't know the history. And so she's not able to be a mother for her children. We will say, out of faith, that she met Jesus while she was in this, under this right here. She met Jesus. Maybe she met this one in you know, coming out of the jail. And then this one comes up. Just happened to come by and say, hey, let me pray for you. And that could be a whole change. And then it affects generations. Of the generations for the next mothers there. So which one of y'all? You good mother? Amen. Bad mother or in between? Sometimes good, sometimes bad. And it's okay because we know as Christians that we can repent. Amen. And ask God to help us. Amen. Because we don't have a journal. We don't have a book. We got the Bible to give us instructions on what to do. But a lot of times you're met with situations where you can't grab that word. Amen. You can't grab that note. You have to make a decision right then, you know. And most of the time, we come in like this. Like, what I tell you? Don't try me today. Praise God. What does the Bible teach us about being a mother? What does the Bible teach us about being a mother? We've got so many examples, but I'm not going to get into all of those. But first of all, I'm going to tell you what really makes a mother is a Christian mother. And in order to be a Christian mother, you have to what? Repent and be saved. That's the first thing you need to do. Woo! First thing you need to do is, I'm going to have to come out of these shoes. Repent and be saved. So a Christian mother, in order, first of all, to receive anything else, you have to be able to submit to the husband. Okay, so if you're not saved, first thing you're going to do is, no, I'm not doing that. That's fine. That's you. But you're making life harder. Amen. For yourself. And for your single mothers, you have to submit to somebody, you know, whether it's on the job, whether it's an uncle or grandpa, somebody. You got to submit to God, you know, if you don't have that husband present. So we're coming out of Titus 2, 4 through 5. And this is out of the NLT, so it reads a little different. Submit to husband. Older women, these older women must train the younger women to love their husbands and their children, to live wisely and be pure, to work in their homes, to do good, and to be submissive to their husbands, to your own husband. Then they will not bring shame on the word of God. So I added a little thing in here. Don't talk bad about your husband to anyone, ever. And I ain't gonna lie, I have. I have a few times. I'm like, sister, you got to help me. And he has called, and that's just getting counsel. I don't talk bad. That's just getting counsel, you know. And then husbands must not talk bad about their wives either. Hello. So, you know, when you're young in your marriage, you're going to do stuff, like make mistakes. And God allows you to repent, okay? And it keeps us humble. So we don't want to talk bad about that person that we're being submissive to. Try your best. We're not perfect. We're going to make mistakes. But try your best not to do that. It causes dishonor. A mother must be able to show love. If anybody know me, I'm full of it. I'm just full of it. Let's go to Isaiah 66 and 13. And if I can get somebody to read that for me, I would appreciate it. As soon as you get it, go ahead. Get it. Love. You got to show love and have love. Okay. 66 and 13.
As a mother confronts her child, so will I confront you, and you will be confronted over Jerusalem.
Amen. When mom shows love, when the mother shows love, she's showing God's love.
Amen.
Okay? She's showing the love of God. So, and this all comes back to, if you're not saved, you won't be able to do any of this. Mm-hmm. So you got to repent, get salvation, and then you can carry on with the rest of this. So the mothers that I grew up with, I was raised by my mom and my grandmother. She was very active in my life. And mama was the go-getter. She was the worker. And so I got my work ethic from mama and how to keep the home. Grandmother was the, come on, you know, the mother hen type woman. And she would just bring us in. So we knew that if we needed hugs or whatever, grandmother. Mama did it too. Mama danced with us. We would dance. And that's how she would show love. We knew mama loved us and grandmother loved us also. And if it wasn't for that, we would not have known anything about love, you know? Okay. And some mothers don't get to experience that from their own mother or grandmother, but there's people that have come into their lives. Amen. that has come and show, yeah, mother figures. Amen. Yeah, spiritual mothers, godmothers, you know, even auntie or a friend, you know. We need that.
Yes.
Okay. Deuteronomy 4:9. Mother has to be wise. She got to be wise, y'all. You don't want to get just fumbling through life, and you go to mother and she's full of just stuff. Like, I'm coming to you for advice. I need you to help me. And you're talking about some stuff that Michael Jackson and stuff. I don't want to hear about that right now. I need you. I need some wisdom. I need some advice. I need some guidance, you know? All right. Deuteronomy 4:9. Gina, can you read that for me? You got it?
They are. Only be careful and watch yourself closely so that you do not forget the things your eyes have seen, or let them fade from your heart as long as you live. Teach them to your children and to their children after them.
Amen.
Amen.
your children, your children's children, your children's children's children. You see that? Generational. Generational. So big mamas, you know, I know I do it a lot, especially with my husband. I say, grandmother used to say, grandmother said this and grandmother said that, because she had these little things that she would say. Mama just give it to you straight. Don't do it. She didn't have no, if you make your bed hard, lay it. She didn't do that. My mom did not do that. She just say, you did it. You figure it out, you know. So, and which was good. But grandmother would always come up with these little sayings. And I was like, what? And I was young during that time. But eventually, as I got older, I'm able to use it. Now I sound like grandmother saying that stuff to my children. See, the decisions you made, you know, now you got to deal with it. So wisdom, mother needs to be wise. She needs to be wise. And especially, she needs to be able to go to the Word of God. You know, give you wisdom from the Word of God. And that's what my mom did a lot. You know, I was the hard-headed one. She said, you got a calling on your life. No, I don't. I don't want to have a calling on my life. Why, it's got to be me. You got three more kids. Get off of my back, you know. And look at her today. She right here supporting my marriage, supporting my grandchildren. I've had my granddaughter has had to live with her. And so she's been there. She's been there. And having a good time. She's reaping now. She's able to come here and visit and just relax and get kisses from my husband. I'm jealous. Like, why is he kissing on her all the time? But his mom has passed away, and so my mom has stepped in and said, I will be his mother. He needs to have a mother. First time she met him, we were just dating and courting. That's the first thing she said. And she has been that. She's kept her word. Yeah. I know. She said, nobody but God. Amen. Mother, comfort. Isaiah 66:13. Mother needs to be a comforter, just like God left us the Holy Spirit to be a comforter. Y'all know what a comforter is? Think about the comforter on your bed when it's cold, you know. You want to put it on and you feel so warm and snug and you just feel comfortable. You feel like you can just twist and turn that comforter. It's not going anywhere. Comforter. Someone to say, you know what, it's all right that you stumped your toe. It's all right that you fail. It's all right. Come here. Come here. Let's talk. Let's talk about it. Taking me by the hand, take the child by the hand and say, let's take a walk. Let me take a few minutes out of my day, listen to you, and let's get this going. Who's got Isaiah 66:13? Read the book. Isaiah 66:13, comfort. Somebody. What? We got a gentleman here. Well, okay. Amen. That word was used quite a bit in that verse. Mm-hmm. You see how God wants us to understand that he is here to be a comforter also, and he has ordained mothers to do that, yes, to give you that physical touch, that physical comfort. Yeah, and I did that a lot with my children. Look at the little boy. He got it. He's like, he looks like he's saying, Mama, I need you. That one right there, he all right. He's all right, yeah. He's like, let the baby have it, because I'm good. I'm good. Strength, dignity, and laughter. Brother Kevin, we'll let you have that one. Proverbs 31:25. Strength. Okay, no problem. Strength, dignity, and laughter. That's three. Proverbs 31:25. Man, mama got to be strong. Y'all see why y'all think we superwoman? She got to be strong and hold her head high and have dignity. Like, that didn't even bother me. Why? She can only do it if she's what? Saved, because she's going to give it to God. Yes. Okay.
She is clothed with strength and dignity. Mm. She can laugh at the days to come.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Amen. Laughter. She can laugh. My husband, he talks about the way I laugh all the time. I can't help it. It comes from, it's real. Mm-hmm. when I'm laughing, it's real. It's going to come from the pit of my belly. Because there was a time in my life, especially going through sickness in and out, where I couldn't laugh. You know, I couldn't hardly talk sometimes. I was on a walker, couldn't hardly walk. And so I had to have people to laugh for me, to talk for me, pray for me, you know. And so now he gets it all because I'm going to let it out. I'm just going to let it. You're going to see all these teeth and braces, the tongue, everything. You're going to get it. Because I'm just full of joy after all that I've been through. And I said at the beginning, sometimes I was a good mom, sometimes a bad mom. My kids will have to be the ones to say that. And I've heard them say, yeah, you was a good mom, but mom, you was crazy, or mama, you was hard on us. Well, I had to be because I knew what was out there in the world, you know? And now when they come around, they love coming around me now because I'm full of laughter and joy, you know, and because they're grown now. They're grown, they have their own children. Yep, so she is cold. Put our clothes on, man. Strength, dignity, and laughter. Nobody wants to come around a weak woman. And I'm not trying to be like, you know, like we all that and whatever. But I'm just saying, be that matriarch that can say, I can handle that because I'm going to give it to Christ. I'm going to give it to Christ to get my husband, let him know what's going on. And we're going to talk together. We're going to pray together. But then I'm also go on the side over here and talk to God myself about that matter. All right, y'all, we bringing it home. This is the last one. Amen. Mama, you got this one. Deuteronomy. I'm trying to slow down. I told you when I'm nervous, I go fast. My mama is fussing at me, y'all. Online. Deuteronomy, mama. You in Deuteronomy? 5:16. Say it loud. This is a good one. No problem. Uh-huh.
Okay.
All right.
Honor thy father and thy mother as the Lord thy God hath commanded thee, that thy days may be prolonged and that it may go well with thee in the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee.
Amen. 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 That's a good one, y'all. Sit down. Do your homework. Yes, ma'am.
Amen.
No, we're not having a snack right now. Yes, ma'am. Mm-hmm. Look at that. I was in the, we were in, I'm not going to say the store because you just don't know who's watching, but we were at a store. It was three generation ladies. Well, it was a mother, the daughter, and then a little girl. She looked like she was about four. Whatever, little mama walking around. She want to walk around. And then the other babies are in the basket, little boy and I think another little girl. So they decided, okay, it's time for the little girl to go get in the basket because it was starting to get congested in the store. Mama said, blinkety blank, 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 blank. Fill in the blanks in the basket. And I just stopped. And I was like, okay. So guess what grandma did? Yeah! Blinkety blank, 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 you know? Fill in the blanks. Yeah. What do y'all think this little baby is going to do when she has her family? Blank, blank, blank. Blinkety blank, 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 blank. Hers is going to be worse. So we got to be careful, y'all. Whenever you have your, I didn't mean to do that one. Whenever you have your children, what you put in them will come out. They will embarrass you. And I just had to stop and just pray for covering for the all the little kids, but especially the little girl, because she was she looks like she's very independent. You know, she has her own mind to do things and things like that, and she's not learning the right stuff. That language is terrible for a young lady. It's terrible. It's terrible, and it comes with a lifestyle. So she's basically cursing. Mama cursed her, and mama cursed her. That little one's going to have kids. She's going to curse them, and it's going to be generational until somebody comes in and say, hey, you're chosen to stop that. You're chosen to not be that. Don't do that. You know, it could be another man that's interested in her. It could be her pastor. It could be an uncle, a brother, or something. Why you talk like that? That's not becoming. You know, that's the devil's language. And to me, I've always told my kids, if you're talking like that, it lets me know you don't have the words to express yourself. You're not intelligent enough to, you know, substitute that word right there for something else. You don't know? Let's go to the dictionary. I pull that dictionary out on my children, and I challenge them all the time. They didn't have time to do that cussing stuff. I found out later in life they was cussing when I wasn't around, but they knew better than not let me hear it. Because I wanted them to do good in life, you know. Not that I wanted them to be perfect, but learn something from mama. Learn something. So happy Mother's Day to, this is my mom, and this is my grandmother. She passed away in 2013. This is Gina's, that's your great aunt. Gina's great aunt, Tay's great, great aunt. And that's the one I'm always talking about, because I think it's because when I got older, I was able to pay attention more, you know, and so a lot of things that she did tell me and teach me, I took it under account, you know, it meant a lot. And then when I started having children, I bounced back over to my mama, you know, and then ailments in my body, I called mama, and she helped me understand a lot of things that was going on in my life health-wise. So happy Mother's Day. So I want to close in prayer. If you all just pray with me. Lord, I thank you. I thank you right now, God. I just believe today that someone has gone to Romans 10, 9 and 10 and asked for your forgiveness. I believe that right now, God, that you released repentance all over this land like never before. Even if it is Mother's Day. Lord God, I just thank you for that right now. Thank you for your Holy Spirit. Thank you, God, for the ones that showed up today. Thank you for the ones that are online. Thank you for the phone calls and the texts that I received. Thank you for making me a mother. In the name of Jesus, I'm so grateful, God. I'm so, even to some that didn't even have a mother, they still tell me Happy Mother's Day. And I thank you for that, God. And right now, Lord, just continue to chase the people, chase the mothers, give them another chance with their children and with their families, Father. In Jesus' name, I pray this prayer. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Okay. Go get that one. Praise God. So y'all be nice to mama today. Take her out to eat.
And thanks, Akil. And so we thank you. We thank you, First Lady, for your come on up here. We thank you so much for you pouring into us today and being transparent. And ain't she pretty, y'all?
Yeah. Hmm?
Hey, she was fine back in the day, too. The prettiest girl in town. Well, she was smoking, boy, I tell you. I wasn't blind.
Oh, God. Still smoking.
Well, she was still smoking, boy. Still smoking, but hey. Yeah. Think about it. So we love you. We pray for you. I want to pray for you because I don't want some mothers out there, the devil's been beating you up about not being the best mother.
Yeah.
But as First Lady was saying today, there's no perfect mother.
No.
Just be there. You don't have to be perfect. And I clap for the women that's just
right.
Be there.
That's right.
You know?
That's right.
Yeah, you let a couple of cuss words out, but kids will bring some cuss words out of you now. They will bring it out of you, but guess what? You were there, right? Mm-hmm. So don't let that beat you up. You need to be proud that you were there. Amen. And for the ones that were not there, as long as you got breath in your body, and your children are alive, you can be there. You can make up. God is a God of a second chance.
Yes, he is.
Amen. Amen. So there's no, this is Mother's Day. Get all that shame out.
Yeah.
Right? Because guess what? You if you gave birth to them and allowed them to live, that's something to give God
that's
glory.
That's right. That's right.
If you carried them for 9 months and you gave your body for them to have life, you should be proud of that. If you didn't do nothing else right, you did that right. And that's something that you can fix it from then on. Amen?
Amen.
So walk with your head up. Be proud today. God loves mothers.
Yes, he does.
Because without you, there would be no life.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
So we thank you today. I'm going to go ahead and pray. And we thank you, First Lady, again, for you and being the mother of this church. And we thank you, Mother Young, for being here, you know, for that. We thank you for the word today. And it was a powerful word of being taught. Amen. How many of y'all enjoyed the word today? Amen. And we're going to have more of that. We're going to start a Thursday session with some of the women here and on Thursdays and have First Lady lead it called Girl Talk. And what we're going to do is set up a studio, and we're just going to sit down with some coffee and just talk about real problems that women and mothers face and be transparent. Why? Because we want to let them know that you aren't alone. You know, don't let the devil think you're the only one made mistakes and you can come out from. So guess what? We're going to love each other. That's right. Like when I raise the men up, we're going to be transparent and maybe give each other keys and share resources on how we get past certain things. Amen.
That's right. Amen.
We need it. Look at your number and say, we need each other.
We need each other.
That's Amen. Right. We need each other. Yeah. And thank you again, Sergeant, for coming up. And this is going to be a regular thing, right? Huh? This your ball from now on, right? Well, you know, whenever, because I know you got to work on Sunday, but you know, you did so good at it. Amen. Amen. And we got things for our great evangelist, Sister Gina, and she's anointed to reach and
right.
preach and do, and things for Mother Young. Amen. Amen. So we're going to go ahead and pray and get out of here. Have a happy Mother's Day. Amen.
Amen.
So let's go ahead and go before God in prayer. Father, we thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
We praise you. And we lift up mothers today, Lord.
Yes, Father.
Yes, yes.
Father, we just ask you, Lord God, to encourage them today. I speak strength, Lord God, over them. Encouragement today, Lord God. Father God, remind them of the good that they did, Lord God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Father God, we cry even for the one that's hungering for a call from their child, Lord
God. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Let them get that call today, Lord God.
Yes, God.
In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord God.
Yes,
Father God, show them grace, show them mercy, Lord God. There is no bad mother, Lord God.
That's right.
Father
That's
God, right. I thank you, Lord God, that you show them your love and your grace today.
Yes, Lord.
I speak peace over them.
Yes, Lord.
I lift the burden of guilt in the name of Jesus
in
Christ,
the name of
and
Jesus.
I speak a father's blessing over them now.
Yes,
and I declare and decree, may your latter be better than your, may your former be better than your latter.
Yes.
I declare and decree that the seed that you've sown in good ground, Lord God, shall come forth today. I declare and decree that what you have lost and sacrificed, the hurt, the pain, the disappointment, I declare as the father
Hallelujah.
Of this house, Lord God, for that to be restored in the name
thank
of Jesus,
Jesus,
that you will get double for your shame.
Yes.
Lord, and I cry out that Hallelujah. It comes back. With speed on it. Put some speed on it, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Put some speed on it, Lord.
Yes, God. Yes, God.
Some of these women are crying out for husbands, Lord God.
Yes, Lord.
Father God, I thank you, Lord God, that they find a man of God, a Boaz, Lord God.
Yes, God.
That's going to love them through and in spite of, Lord God.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
It's going to see the good and the treasure in them, Lord God.
Yes,
and
Lord.
Father God, celebrate them for who they are,
yes,
Lord, that
God.
They don't have to be anybody else, Lord God. Send them men that are going to adore them for who they are, Lord
yes,
God.
Lord.
Right where
yes,
they are, Lord,
Lord
God. In Jesus' name,
in
we
Jesus
pray.
Name we pray.
Amen. Amen. Hey, look, this is Dr. Charles C. Lucas and First Lady Bonita Lucas saying, keep moving.
Amen.
You keep moving, Tweety Bird.
Keep moving.
Amen. All right. Okay. Man, thank you.